Thank you, John. Welcome, everyone. As John said, thank you for making the effort to be here today. I'm sure many of you are up against difficult circumstances at home, and I'm here charging my phone as well. So I know what it feels like, and we appreciate you making the effort to come today. It's been a real pleasure. It's a real pleasure and a real honor to work with Dr. Chabot and be a part of the Pancreas Center. And Dr. Chabot asked me to talk a little bit today about ERCP and EUS, which I won't go into what they stand for, but what they are the endoscopic procedures that patients initially encounter when they are suspected to have a problem in their pancreas. And in a way, it's very appropriate that I'm speaking first because frequently this is how a patient with a problem in their pancreas, this is their first interaction with the medical community. Patients with pancreatic cancer frequently present with something called painless jaundice. When you're a medical student, you learn a lot of different flash text words, and this is the classic pearl, painless jaundice. When a patient comes into the emergency room with painless jaundice, the first thing you're supposed to think of is pancreatic cancer. And why is that? Because when someone has a problem in their pancreas, the bile duct, which is where the liver drains the bile into the intestine, the bile duct runs through the pancreas. And so when something's growing in the pancreas, it blocks the bile duct. And patients with pancreatic cancer frequently don't have a tremendous amount of pain. They might have some back pain, but they frequently present with painless jaundice. And when they're jaundiced, we need to do something to alleviate the jaundice. Frequently, these patients have a lot of itchiness and lethargy and just don't feel quite right. And the way that we alleviate that jaundice is by doing something called an ERCP. And that stands for endoscopic retrograde cholangiopancreatography, which is a very long word. So from now on, I'm just going to say ERCP. On the left is a normal ERCP. And an ERCP is an endoscopic procedure where we have the patient in the endoscopy unit. They're lying on their stomachs. They're actually on an X-ray table. And we go in endoscopically through their mouths and go down past the stomach into the small intestine where there's a little hole, which I'm going to show you in a second, where the pancreatic duct, which is this duct, and the bile duct both empty through this little hole, which is the papilla. And when patients, as I showed you before, have a problem in their pancreas, both of these ducts get blocked. And the ducts dilate, because just like plumbing in your house, if something isn't getting through, the ducts dilate and juices back up. And the liver duct is supposed to be here. And you can see we've placed a stent, which is just a metal mesh tube, inside the bile duct to help get the bile out and relieve the patient's jaundice. This is a quick video clip. Oops, I was hoping to show that. Which is a little old, but it's an oldie but goodie. Where we're showing us, this is the papilla where I showed you the bile duct and the pancreatic duct, both empty into the intestines. So what we're trying to do here is get a wire into the bile duct so that we can deploy a stent over the wire into the bile duct and open things up and have the patient's jaundice resolve. And this could be a little bit of a tricky situation because we're working in a very small space and we're doing our best to get into the bile duct and not get into the pancreatic duct. Again, it's an endoscopic procedure, so the patients typically are coming in as outpatients, and the only preparation is just nothing to eat or drink after midnight. They don't need to go through any bowel cleansing or anything like that. Once we've secured access to the bile duct, we're able to do the things that we need to do to help the patient's jaundice resolve. The other thing that we do is, when they come in with painless jaundice, is we need to establish a diagnosis. And one of the frequent ways that we do that is by doing a biopsy of the pancreas endoscopically. And patients are very surprised that we're able to do that. But the same way, what I tell them is the same way when you have an ultrasound and you can see on the other side of the wall of the stomach, we have a special scope, which I'm showing you here, which has an ultrasound probe on the end of it. And you can see an ultrasound image on the other side of the wall of the stomach. The pancreas lives on the other side of the wall of the stomach. And using this as guidance, we can pass a needle through the scope into the pancreas, pull out the stylet of the needle, so now the needle is hollow, and take a biopsy of the pancreas. And the vast majority of the time, this is how we're making a diagnosis. And in some ways, I spend a lot of my time kind of preparing patients for this and giving them this news. And it's not often easy because you kind of know, as many of you in the audience know, the road that lies ahead of them. And it has to be done in the most gentle kind of way possible. This is an example of what the pancreas looks like with a mass in it. And this is the bile duct, which I showed you both of those ducts emptying into the papilla. This is what a mass in the pancreas looks like. And we can also use endoscopic ultrasound to help us stage the tumor. So as I'm sure Dr. Chabot and others will talk about, depending on where the tumor is, whether it's involving vessels, the patients might have to get chemotherapy or radiation prior to surgery. And this is just a quick video of what an endoscopic ultrasound looks like endoscopically. Sorry, I lost the mouse. So rather than seeing the inside of the intestine, now we're using an ultrasound image to guide us. And by moving the scope, we get different images of the mass that we want to biopsy. You can see the needle coming out, and we pass the needle through the wall into the pancreas and suction out some cells, put it on a slide, and we actually have somebody inside the room able to give us a diagnosis right away. So these are just a couple of the things that that I do in helping take care of these patients. And it's a real honor, as I said, to be here today and talk to you all a little bit more about the things that we do. I think I'm going to introduce Ron Arancio to talk a little bit more about those things as well.